Compositing digital elements into a scene is something very common nowadays, and with little effort, you can add this little extra that will bring your video to the next level. In today's tutorial, we'll have fun compositing some text into a scene where the camera is moving with both static and moving subjects. And for this, we'll use the ever so useful Planar Tracker. Let's get started. First, thank you to everyone watching and subscribing to our channel. This means a lot to us. And if you haven't subscribed already and would like to support this channel into making more tutorials, think about doing so. The footage to practice along this tutorial is available to download in the description below. This scene is just a few beautiful animals hanging around and was not meant to be cinematic at all, but as we shot it midday without an ND filter, the sky was completely clipped and we had to do a quick sky replacement to make it usable. This kind of effect can be a little tricky when there's a lot of camera motion, particularly when the trees here in the background are moving with the wind, and we did not want to spend too much time on it. If you would like us to make a tutorial about how to replace a sky in a video using different techniques, please leave us a comment. Let's jump into DaVinci Resolve. If you downloaded our clip or using one with the H.264 or H.265 codec, this is not production friendly, and we recommend that you create a proxy if your system starts to slow down after adding few effects. We do have a dedicated tutorial about how to handle your media for better performance, but this can be done very easy at any time by right-clicking on the clip and choosing Generate Proxy Media. Just make sure that in the playback menu, you have the option Use Proxy Media if available checked, as this will update your timeline automatically. Without any more delay, let's jump to the Fusion page. To start decorating the shade and give it some style, select Media In, type Ctrl or Shift Space depending if you're on PC or Mac, and type Plan. Select Planar Tracker and add it. We first need to set our reference time for the tracker, and for this I'm gonna pick the last frame as this is offering a clear view on the whole shade. I'll go to the inspector, click on Set, and at any time if you need to get back quickly to this frame, just use the Go button. The Planar Tracker is going to track a texture and we need to set those different parameters to match the motion in the shot. I'm going to change the tracker type to Hybrid Pond Area as this will be more suited for the type of texture that we're going to track. For motion type, as the camera is panning, rotating and slightly moving on the Z axis, I'm going to change it to Translation, Rotation and Scale. This will instruct the tracker on what type of motion to expect. I'm going to zoom on the shade and I'm going to trace the area that I want to track. This area doesn't need to be particularly large, but you do need enough details for the tracking to be accurate. I'm going to zoom out, and because this is the last frame, I'll be using Track to start tracking. After the tracking is complete, I'm going back to the reference time and change the operation mode to Corner Pin. The polygon here represents the plane and the perspective that will be used to apply your text, so you must place each corner as accurately as possible. For now, I'm just going to place them roughly, zoom in the shot, and arrange them one by one. It is only after adding the text that we'll be able to make precise adjustments. To add the text, drag the text tool into the node views and connect it to the Planar Tracker. Enter your text and format it as you like. Move the text around in the layout tab. I'm gonna move it down on the Y axis. There you are. And if you find your text to be a little distorted, you can get back to the Planar Tracker and make a few adjustments to make sure that everything is placed exactly as you like. The more accurate you are, the better it will look. Now that the text is matching the camera motion, let's blend in a little more realistically to the shade. For this, with the Planar Tracker selected, open the corner pin one, and for apply mode, change it for something that works for your design and background. Overlay works pretty great when you want something really subtle like blending a texture, but for this one, I'll go for color dodge and bring down the gain to something like 0.65. Okay, that's pretty good. Got the actual degree. Let's switch to the edit page to see how it looks. I'm going to zoom in to have a clear view of the effect and play. And as you can see, the text is sticking to the surface pretty well. And if someone was unaware of the change and watching this clip, he would probably have no idea that this was added digitally. Now, what if we want to add extra elements to that shade? The process is actually straightforward and often doesn't require any additional tracking. If they are on the same plane, you can get away by adding extra corner pins to a single planar tracker. And this is particularly handy when you need overlapping elements or textures. To add a new corner pin, click on the plus button next to the corner pin count and this will add another corner pin to the list. This is adding a new input to the planar tracker node and you can actually go crazy and add more inputs that you ever need. To clean that mess, you can use the minus button to delete the last corner pin on that list. But if you need to remove one that sits in between, you're out of luck. You will either need to edit manually the planar tracker in a text editor or swap the input with another one and reorganize all the corners manually. Or far quicker, you can just disable any corner pin and forget about it. Let's clean up the mess. Okay, and I'm going to drag a text tool into the node view and connect it to the new input. I'm going to speed through the text formatting. The idea behind adding more elements is not necessarily to make them large and eye-catching, but more to add to the whole scene. You might not even be able to read it on a smaller screen, but it is there and it will tickle your brain. Let's take care of that beautiful donkey by adding a funny message. To composite onto organic or wrapping surfaces, we would normally use something like Mocha Pro to create a power mesh to be able to apply the text. But for this, Fusion Planar Tracker would be enough and far quicker. Let's move those three nodes. Select media in, control or shift space, plan, and we're gonna add a new planar tracker. As before, set the tracker point to hybrid point area, motion type to transition rotation scale. To make sure that the tracking is stable, I'm going to trace the polygon over its side while avoiding hips and shoulders. Gonna make some adjustments. The planar tracker can deal with some wrapping, but there's only so much it can handle, so try avoiding any area that could cause severe wrapping. Let's not forget to set the reference time and start tracking. Tracking went pretty well and we can now switch the operation mode to corner pin. Place each corner. Add a new text node that we're going to connect to the planar tracker and format it as we did before. Make sure to adjust the perspective to match the surface. When working on organic surfaces, you need to be extra careful, but even with the planar tracker limitation, you can achieve some good results. In the color page, I'm just going to add a little contrast and check how it looks. Look at how the text is adapting pretty nicely to the surface, and imagine what you could do with this kind of compositing. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe, and don't forget to check out playlists about VFX and DaVinci Resolve. And we'll see you in the next video. See ya!